guys, what's up? It's Natalie. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Happy Vlogmas day 7, and today I'm going to be sharing with you guys 20 gift ideas for Christmas slash the holidays. So yeah, without further ado, let's just get into it. So I have my list on my phone, and I thought about it about also, you guys can see that. I think I got a mosquito bite. I don't really know. But this is basically a list that I came up with that I, like my parents, I think would like this kind of stuff. My sister would like this kind of stuff, and my boyfriend would like this kind of stuff. So I feel like these kind types of videos are kind of hard to do because like everyone is so unique and different. However, I'm not saying I bought my mom any of this or my sister or my boyfriend any of this, but these are some ideas that you can actually do and get. And yeah, and I also have 5 budget-friendly gift ideas if you guys are kind of struggling for the holidays and kind of like don't want to spend a lot of money but also want to get a gift for your family members slash loved ones. So I'm going to start with parents. I have a mom, and I was kind of thinking about what she would want for Christmas. I even asked her what she wanted for Christmas, and she said she wanted home decor. But I'm like, what kind of home decor? Like, be specific. And she was like, I don't know. So I literally took all of November to hear what she liked and like wanted. So that's what I did. I literally was like, oh, this is cool. What do you think about this? And she'd be like, oh, I like it. Oh, I don't like it. So this is kind of the list that I have put together for her. So the first thing is an espresso machine. So these are kind of pricey. However, you can also get deals off of like Black Friday or Cyber Monday, even though those have passed. Kind of a good deal. But an espresso machine, my mom is old fashioned and likes like the whole coffee machine. She doesn't even have like a Keurig. But I know when we go to Disney, she loves the Keurig. So my sister has an espresso machine, and my mom was like, oh my god, this is like the best thing. So I was like, ooh. Okay, next thing is slippers around the house. I know my mom gets really cold, especially during the winter. We live in Florida, so it doesn't get that cold, but in her house it's pretty cold. So I was like, oh, she could use some nice slippers. Who doesn't like slippers, you know? Slippers and socks. So gift number 3 is a picture frame. So I feel like the older generation loves to have physical copies of things, not digital. My mom especially, she has like billions of photos in her house. And just print out like a very cute picture of you and your parents, or you and your mom, you and your dad, and boom, that's an easy gift. You can even make a picture frame. I bought mine, but gift number 4 is if your parents have like a favorite TV show, that's always a good idea to kind of like go off of that. Like, I remember my dad used to love The Walking Dead. So one year we got him a mug, t-shirts, a blanket, socks, like anything The Walking Dead we bought. And he loved all of it, and I still have one of his mugs. That's like very worn out. But he loved the gift. He really, really loved the gift. So that's always a good idea to find like what your parents love to watch. So gift number 5 is pretty cool because you can either buy it at a store like Target, Walmart, Amazon, literally anywhere, or you can customize it. So I've seen people customize this gift too. So gift number 5 is a blanket. I know what you're thinking, Natalie. Everyone has a blanket. My mom has a billions of blankets. When I tell you, there's one for Christmas, there's probably 5 for Halloween, there's a dozen Disney blankets. Like, we have every kind of blanket you could possibly think of, but I think it'd be cool if she had like a customized one that you can like print out a picture. There's probably like a lot of websites that you can go on and they can do it for you, which is pretty cool. So I think that would be a really nice gift too. Plus, it'd be like a memory kind of thing. And they can have it forever. Also, if you guys see stuff right here, this is like all my Christmas stuff I still need to wrap. But that will be in another video. Moving on, so siblings. I feel like my sister is so hard to shop for. Actually, this year she made a registry, kind of like a baby registry, and she put a bunch of stuff that she wanted down and what size, and it's crazy. But it was pretty cool because she gave us like a good idea of what she wanted for Christmas. So the first thing I thought would be a cool item would be a Nintendo Switch. I know those used to be super popular and I feel like any age really could use it. They're pretty fun. Even though they're kind of expensive and more on like the expensive side, I feel like it's a good holiday gift. If you have more than one sibling, you can like go to your other sibling and be like, do you want to split the price of this, and then get it for the other sibling. I feel like that'd be a cool gift, you know? Plus, for other holidays, you can get them like games too. So then you'll always have like a little gift in mind, you know what I mean? Gift number two is definitely AirPods. I feel like everyone has AirPods, everyone loves headphones. I recently just got AirPods and they are life changing. And I feel like I'm really late on this like little bandwagon, but I used to have like the big Beats, and those actually caught on fire because I lit a candle and it was on my vanity and the headphones slid down into the candle, so they got kind of burnt. So AirPods, I feel like can't do that. Even though they are a little more expensive, I feel like the older generations are more affordable if you are looking for a nice gift but not like crazy expensive. Gift number three is a scrapbook. So like I said, a lot of the older generation likes more physical copies of stuff, and I feel like more my generation now too, kind of going through the same thing. Like we like printed photos. Like I have a friend who loves having like those actual old-fashioned cameras that like were in the 90s, and she prints out all of her photos. And I think it'd be cool if you took all those photos of the year and then put them in like a scrapbook and kind of either write like a message behind them, like on this day we took this picture in Italy and we had pasta and like whatever. That would be a cool idea. Gift number four is a coloring set, and I feel like this is great for anyone too, younger or older. My sister has a coloring set, I have a coloring set, my planner is actually kind of like a coloring set. And it's very relaxing too to just color and like shut the world out and not be on your phone, so definitely that's a good gift. Number five, I feel like whenever I need a gift from my sister, the best gift I can actually think of is makeup. She loves makeup, and I feel like even when you're younger, kids do like experiment with makeup. So even if you go to like Claire's or Target and get them like the little makeup set, that'd be a good gift for them. Or if you have like an older sister, someone who's better at makeup, you can go to Ulta. They sometimes have good sales and get them like a little nice makeup palette. Okay, my camera is flashing, so I'm just gonna have to go like as fast as I can now. So the next is boyfriend/girlfriend. I'm gonna do boyfriend because I have a boyfriend, and these are kind of the items that I was like, okay, he could possibly use. Number one would be boxers. I feel like a guy cannot have too many boxers/underwear. Like, I don't know. I feel like every guy needs dozens of pairs of underwear. Like, I have billions of underwear. Like, I have way too many underwear. But besides the point, I feel like he should have the same amount as me. So I feel like a pack of boxers would be great. Number two, I have like a general kind of number two, but basically shirts, jeans, and shoes. I feel like once you ask your boyfriend what size he is, you can go shopping for like all of his like wardrobe stuff. And it's good because if you have like a certain vibe, you can just like put your vibe into his clothes, so then when you guys go out, you guys can kind of be matching. Number three, my boyfriend actually asked for this for Christmas, but then ended up buying it himself. Tools. So when something breaks around the house, he can just Bob the Builder and fix it all up without you being like, oh my gosh, we need to call someone to fix it. He can fix it because now he has tools. Gift number four is cologne. Last year I bought Sam cologne and he uses it a lot actually. I got him like the Paxson one, but this could be a good gift because it could either be super expensive or kind of cheap, and it kind of like lets them have like the ability to have something new too, but still something similar at the same time. Like everyone wears perfume or cologne, so it's like, why not try a different scent, you know what I mean? And number five, my boyfriend actually got me this for our anniversary, but he got me like this picture of the stars on the night we met. And it's basically like the satellite, is it called? I don't know, but it's like all the stars, like when we met and the exact locations. That was a good gift, and I was like, wow, so thoughtful, and I was not expecting that whatsoever. Moving on to budget-friendly gift ideas, I feel like everyone wants to save a little bit of money here and there. I feel like these gifts are pretty good with saving money and being more on the cheap side. Gift number one, I already said this, but a scrapbook. I feel like you don't have to have like a bunch of photos. Even if you have old photos, you can just get a scrapbook online on Amazon, maybe for like $10, and put all the old photos in that and be like, oh my gosh, look at all the nice memories we had. I can't wait to make more. And then you can leave some open pages like left in the scrapbook and be like, these are gonna be for all the adventures that we're going to go on in the future. Bada bing, bada boom. Number two. So gift number two I thought of because I received one recently and I was like, oh my God, this is so cool. I've never had one of these, but I've always like seen them on Pinterest. It's open this, it's like the little letters that say open this when, and then it says like when you're sad, when you're happy, when you're celebrating something. Like I have some of those and I feel like they help so much. So even if you just make a box and put these like little tiny individual handwritten, open this when you're feeling blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean? I feel like those are like more like a sentimental kind of gift that everyone would love and appreciate. Gift number three, I did not know existed at all. But if you go on the Target app, there's a category that says gifts under $5 or gifts under $15. You could say like either one. But you basically click on it and then it shows you like everything they have on sale right now or under $5 or $15, whatever category you do choose. It has like a bunch of gifts. So you're like, oh, click, 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 click. You can get like five things for only $25 if you get the $5, you know, category. So I feel like you can find anything there. Cute, simple, cheap, and everyone's like, oh my gosh, you got me a new gift. And you're like, yes, I did. I really thought about it. Gift number four, I used to do this when I was little to my mom and my dad, was coupons. So like, I would make a little coupon and it'd be like, free massage, free day to go get ice cream, like stupid things like that. I feel like when you're little, that's very cute and your parents would really appreciate. I personally love anything that's like handmade, hand drawn. So I feel like that's a cute gift, like little coupons, and you can like wrap like a little bow on it. And gift number five is a candle. So some candles can be super expensive, but others can be super cheap. You just kind of have to find good candles. I know Walmart probably has some. Amazon has one. You don't have to spend a lot of money on candles like at Yankee Candle or anything. You can also get stuff that are out of season. Like I know when Christmas is over, a lot of the Christmas smells go on clearance so you can stock up for the next year. So those are kind of budget friendly kits. Anyways guys, that is it for today's video. I hope you guys liked it. I really thought kind of hard on these gifts. I wasn't sure like what I should even include without giving away what I bought for my mom, sister, and boyfriend. But yeah, I hope you guys liked this video and I hope it helped you guys too. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.